XFM News. On point. News on XFM. I'm Chris or Tim. Preparations and mobilizations are in high gear at Muni University in West Nile, where the Ugandan President Yoweri Museveni will meet the flag bearers and the incumbent members of parliament and the party officials from Arua City, Arua District, Maracha, Terego, Koboko, and Okolo districts, all in West Nile. The president is expected to be in that region until Saturday. Joyce Samaguru, the acting NRM chairperson for Arua City, says they are ready to host the president as well as comb the votes for him. Tomorrow, Friday, the president will be in Nebi, where he will meet the NRM officials, flag bearers, and incumbent MPs before heading to Moyo for the same purpose and for the districts of Adjumani, Moyo, Obongi, and Yumbe. The independent presidential candidate, retired General Henry Tumukunde, has said that if any leader is to help the Chigezi sub-region to prosper, he should study its natural setup. Tumukunde says that Chigezi's peculiar terrain is the cause for the land shortage problem in the area, which has led to the encroachment of wetlands in that part of the country. He said that most residents occupy lowland areas and wetlands because their terrain does not favor them to stay and practice agriculture in the highlands. Tumukunde was on Thursday morning addressing the media at Kefas Inn in Kabale after concluding his campaigns in the Chigezi sub-region.
You know very, very well, the fabric of leadership of Uganda was from Kigezi. But we are slowly losing space. This is because our educational systems are no longer functional, or at least we've not given it sufficient effort. Now, an area in a corner of Uganda and in the borders of Congo and Rwanda should be having a very big commercial hospital, which can be used to create money. And we use this money to run other medical services. So I want us to look at other ways of creating wealth. And this is because we want to tap the huge neighborhoods which do not have, you know, as much opportunity or as...
The FDC's Intungamo Municipality MP Perez Rumanzi says he will continue with his anti-shaving campaign in protest at the amendment of the constitution that resulted into the lifting of the presidential age and term limits. Rumanzi, a journalist by profession, says he hasn't visited his barber since the 14th of November 2017, when the 1995 Ugandan constitution was amended to remove the presidential age and term limits. He disclosed this during the opening of the Ntungamo Municipality FDC offices.
I and some other activists across the country, we decided to have a symbol on our bodies that would symbolize that we were discontented with the change of the constitution to remove Article 102B from the constitution of the Republic of Uganda. I decided to grow my hair and my beards so that I don't shave before the term limits or the age limit returns into the constitution. I have kept this for 3 years, and I hope to keep on until President Museveni leaves power or the term limits is restored in the constitution. This is the symbol of the struggle. One of the things that I have offered myself to stand as an MP for Ntungamo Municipality is that the people of municipality send me to parliament, that I become a symbol of discontent of the people of Ntungamo.
In African news, Tanzanian opposition leader Tundu Lissu has said that he received death threats that prompted his departure to Belgium. Mr. Lissu said the security given to him when he was a presidential candidate was withdrawn after the election results were announced and he started receiving death threats. I was called by people who said that an order for them to deal with me once and for all, as they put it, was out, and therefore they advised me to run for my dear life. And that's what I did, he said. Mr. Lissu said he was a legal resident of Belgium and wanted to continue with the fight internationally. And that's the latest XFM News. XFM News.